So in this class, we are going to prove one more theorem. So here, the theorem is a subgroup H of a group G is normal if and only if every right coset of H in G is a left coset of H in G. So this is the statement of the theorem. This is the statement of the theorem, and we prove this theorem. So here, what is given? A group G is given, and then H is a subgroup of G is also given, right? So then we have to show that every right coset of H in G is a left coset of H in G. Okay, so now we prove this theorem. So proof here, what we assume, let H be a normal subgroup of G. So let H be a normal subgroup of G. Okay, let H be a normal subgroup of G. So then what we have to show? We have to show that every right coset of H in G is a left coset of H in G. Okay, so now since H is a normal subgroup, okay, so now as H is a normal subgroup, as H is a normal subgroup, so this implies by the definition of a normal subgroup, GHG inverse is equal to H by previous theorem. So for all G belongs to G. So now multiplying both the sides with G. So GHG inverse G is equal to H into G. Again, this is for all G belongs to G, or this can be written as GH, split this GH, then correct these two, GH then G inverse G is equal to HG for all G belongs to G, for all G belongs to G. So that means this is G H, then G inverse into G is nothing but E, identity element, is equal to H into G. GH into E is again, this implies GH is equal to HD. Now see here, this is a right coset and this is a left coset. So therefore, this implies every right coset of H in G is equal to left coset of H in G. So this we proved the first part now. Okay, next we prove the sufficient condition, that is conversely. What we assume? We assume that let every left coset of H is equal to right coset of H in G. Okay, conversely, let GH is equal to HD. GH is equal to HD. So then what we have to show? We have to show H is normal in G. To show that H is normal in G, we prove that GH G inverse is equal to H. We prove this relation. GH G inverse is equal to H. Very simple. So now multiply with G inverse. So this implies GH, multiply both the sides by G inverse. GH G inverse is equal to HG G inverse. Okay, so or GH G inverse is equal to H into G G inverse is nothing but E, identity element, or which is equal to H into E is equal to H, because any identity element is multiplied with some other element, again it gives the same element, that is H. So this implies GH G inverse is equal to H, so which means H is normal in G. H is normal in G. So this is the proof of this theorem. Okay, so next one more theorem we prove now. So we have one more theorem, that is so it states that a subgroup H of the group is a subgroup H of the group G is normal in G if and only if the product of any two right cosets of H in G is again a right coset of H in G. Okay, so this is the statement of this theorem. So here what is given, what we have to show? Here a group G is given and H be a subgroup of G, then H is normal in G if and only if The product of any two right cosets of H in G is again a right coset in G. So here we take two right cosets, we take two right cosets and we multiply those two right cosets, and after multiplying and whatever we obtain, and that is also right coset. So this we have to show. So proof. So here let H is B normal in G. We have to show that let H be a normal in G. We have to assume this one. Let H be a normal in G. Then we have to show. Okay. Then we have to show every two right cosets of H in G is again a right coset. So this is a necessary part. So let H be a normal in G. Next, what we do? We take two right cosets. So let HA and HB, HB, HA and HB be two right cosets. Let HA and HB, HA and HB be two right cosets, right cosets. Now we multiply that HA into HB is equal to. Now this can be written as H into bracket, then club this AH and like the last B, or which is equal to H into. Now this AH can be written as HA because H is normal, H is normal. So therefore AH is equal to HA because every right coset is equal to left coset. Just now we have proved that the theorem. So this is AH is equal to HA and this is B. Or this is can be written as H into H and then this is AB. Or this is equal to H into H is again H. This is AB. So therefore here we have taken HA into HB. This is one right coset. So this, because how we can show that, how we say that it is a right coset, because here, now see here, this is an element A. If this element A if it appears on the right side of this H or right side of this H, then we say that it is a right coset. So here A appears at the right side of this H and B also appears at the right side of this H. So therefore these are two right cosets. So this product of two right cosets is equal to, now when A is an element, B is an element, if you multiply those two, then AB is the product of two elements, is also an element, right? So therefore HAB, so again this element appears at the right side of this H, again this is a right coset. So therefore HA into HB is again HB. So therefore product of two right cosets, product of two right cosets is again a right coset, is again a right coset. Okay, so now we proved the necessary part. Next we prove the sufficient. Conversely, let every product of two right cosets is equal to, is again a right coset. So okay, let product of two right cosets, product of two right cosets of H in G is again a right coset, is again a right coset. We assume this one. Now so for that what we do, we take two again right cosets. So now let HX and HX inverse be two right cosets, be two right cosets. Okay, so then Then according to this statement, what we have? Product of two right cosets is again h into, by using this one, h into x, x inverse, or it is h only. So hx into hx inverse is equal to h. So now what we do? Let take let h1 x take any element h1 x into h2 x inverse belongs to h. Okay, so this implies, so from this equation, if you consider these two, h1 x into h2 x inverse, then this belongs to h because this is equal to capital H. So these two elements belongs to H. Actually what happened, H1X and H2X inverse, these are the elements of this set. These two elements are elements of this set. So when this is equal to H, so that means what? This belongs to capital H. Now which implies multiplying with H inverse, H1 inverse. Okay, multiply both the sides with H1 inverse. So then it becomes H1 inverse into H1 into X, H2, X inverse. Multiply both the sides with H1 inverse belongs to H1 inverse H, H1 inverse F. Now H1, H1 inverse gives identity element E. Vx, H2, X inverse belongs to H1 inverse, or E into this element is again the same element, X, H2, X inverse belongs to, now this H inverse into H is again H, because H inverse, H1 inverse into H is equal to H only, So therefore, this implies by the definition of the normal subgroup, if GH, G inverse belongs to that H, then clearly that is a normal subgroup. So this implies H is normal in G. H is a normal subgroup. H is a normal subgroup. So this is the proof of the second theorem. So that's all for today's session. And we will continue in the next classes with new theorems. Okay, so thank you.